Money. It's got to be one of the most highly charged topics for business owners and for people all around the world. You know, with things like saying, most business owners, if they get rich, they've got to be crooks. Money's the root of all evil. You can't be rich and happy at the same time. All of these crazy ideas. We're going to dive into these today and give you some helpful beliefs around what healthy money beliefs are that you need to be successful. Now, it's interesting because even though we've had this pandemic for the last couple of years, there's still a lot of people out there who've done very, very well with their business. So let's rip in and help you find some more cash in your business today. So here's the five things we're going to look at today in this video. Number one, what is money? Where's this money thing come from? And a bit of a history about how it got to. Number two, we're going to have a look at a definition of money that most people know about it being a means of exchange. We're going to take it to a new level. Number three, I'm going to give you a brand new definition that most people, when they hear this, completely flips on their head what money's all about, and they can see it completely differently and start to actually make some more money. Number four, we're going to look at what are some of the unhealthy beliefs you may have that are stopping you from making a lot more money. And finally, number five, we're going to look at what sort of helpful money beliefs do you need that are going to really get you jumping ahead to make some more money with your business. G'day everyone, my name is Brad Flynn. I'm the author of Find Your Cash. You can actually download a free digital version of my book today in the description section. So jump in, get your copy. Let's rip in and find out where you're leaving money on the table right now. Money. What is this thing called money anyway? What do we need it? What's it all about? Where's it come from? Well, if we go back thousands and thousands of years, we used to have the situation where people wanted to exchange different things of value to them so that they could go on and live their happily lives. So maybe they would want to swap a cow for a container of rice or something, but it became pretty hard over the years to carry all those things to the marketplace and then back again, particularly if you didn't really want to sell something. So that's where they started coming up with this idea of a means of money and using things like coins and gold and those sorts of things to swap value so that you didn't have to carry all your animals and all your stock and all your bits and pieces to the markets. Second thing, as a formal definition, money is a means of exchange of value. Okay, so exchange means to swap things, we're going to exchange. But the key point here in this definition is value. And value is such a spongy thing because value to one person may not be valued to another thing, to another person. So this is where money came in because we now had a standardized thing of what value meant. If you have a $50 note, and someone offers you something that they think is worth $50, but it's not valuable to you, then you're not gonna give over the money. You're not gonna see it as a fair exchange. You're not gonna see Newton's law. It will be violated in that the energy that you see in the value of this thing is not matched by the other person, so there won't be any deal. And this is where the point of money is an exchange of value comes from. It comes back to the value for the individual and what they see is most important in that exchange. It must be fair exchange, win-win for both parties, or it's no deal. Now let's dive into that third point that I wanted to make today. And this definition of money has been game-changing for so many people that I work with that it completely blows their mind. So here we go. Money is an idea backed by confidence. Now, in a business context, when we're selling a product or a service or a combination of both, that's our idea. And we're selling that to the marketplace. Now, that idea has to be backed by confidence and confidence from both parties. And the confidence is actually where the exchange takes place of value. If I don't believe in what I'm selling, then I'm not going to sell it. So if you have an idea but no confidence, then there's going to be no transfer of energy or no transfer of money. If you have confidence and no idea, same thing. Nothing's going to happen. But when you get an idea backed by confidence, and the confidence needs to be between two parties, it needs to be between you. You've got to have confidence in what you're selling, and the person buying it has to have confidence that when they get it, it's going to give them value that's something important to them. Now, one of the things that has a tremendous impact on your confidence is your belief structure. And we're going to talk about beliefs coming up in the next two parts of the video. check out in the description section. This is the first time I've ever done this. I'm actually going to have my ebook version available for you to download. In there, it looks at the 17 most popular strategies for any business that will help you find extra cash in your business. There's a case study in here for a small business that helps them find over $100,000 in extra cash in the next 12 months. Download your copy now, and if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do that as well. Point number four, what we're going to look at now is unhelpful money beliefs. What are the beliefs that are stopping you from making you more money in your business? Fundamentally, let's go back to the word belief, okay? A belief is something you hold to be true. Now, is it a fact? Nope, not necessarily. You might remember when you were a child, there was a guy in a big red suit with a big white beard that magically appeared every year and brought you presents, and you had no idea where they came from and you believed in him. So beliefs are a very subjective thing and they are able to be changed. But the first thing you got to do with having a belief is becoming consciously aware of it. Now let's take a look at the word belief. If we swap the last two letters of the word around, the word actually becomes belief. So if you have unhelpful money beliefs, then that will be life for you. So let me ask you a fundamental question. If you treated your spouse or some of your best friends the same way that you treated money, would they hang around? So making sure we've got these unhelpful beliefs sorted and pulled out is vitally important if we're going to start making some more money. Some of those beliefs will be, there's never enough money to pay the bills. I never have the money when I need it to pay other people. There's not enough money out in the world. Well, here's the thing. The truth is there is literally billions of dollars zipping past you right now through the ether, through the internet with financial transactions. So it's not that there's not enough money out there. So an unhelpful money belief is anything that makes it bad. How do you know a belief? Well, you'll say things like, I believe this to be true, or this is what I think, or whatever it is that you believe, and think about some of the other things that you believe in. If it's negative, the chances of you having lots of money around you with a negative money belief are pretty much zero. Point number five, what are the most helpful money beliefs you can have as a business owner to make sure that your relationship with money improves and thus your bank balance starts to improve as well? Now keep in mind that original definition I had about money is an idea backed by confidence. If you're not confident in what you're doing, then it's going to be hard to accumulate a lot of money. Particularly in business, you've got to know and understand your numbers. You'll see down in the description area a free course that I offer that is called the Small Business Financials Course. Jump in, do that. That will give you the confidence you need to start making more money. So that's one of the first things that you can do. Next of all, you've got to really have confidence in what you're doing. If you're trying to sell a product or a service that you don't really believe in it, then what'll happen is the people you're talking to will pick up on it like that. Humans have these neurons or brain cells that are called mirror neurons, and we pick up on those reflections of other people. So if you're not believing what you're doing, then the other person is going to pick up on it, and that confidence is going to be eroded, and that means of exchange, idea backed by confidence, just ain't going to happen. It won't be win-win and there will be no deal. So you've got to do what you need to make sure that you absolutely believe in what you're selling at 100%. Whenever I'm working with new clients, I go in and start to talk to them and it's like, if you don't work with me, you must be crazy. Do you know what I've done with other business owners who are in your position? Having that confidence might seem a bit arrogant, but it's a fine line. Having self-confidence in it is what we're talking about here, not an arrogant confidence. Now, like I talked about, how you treat a friend. Are you respectful to your friends and your significant other? Of course you are. So if you're not showing respect to money and treating money in a way that it's going to be valued and appreciated, then there's no way it's going to hang around. So you've got to work out how do you start to show respect to money. Things like do a budget, don't waste it, don't blow it away, don't undervalue it. All of those sorts of things. You know, if you don't speak negatively about it, a bit like your friends. You wouldn't go up to a friend and have a big verbal spray at them because they're not going to hang around. Well, when you're having challenges with your money, is that what you're doing? You're having a whole series of negative thoughts that are not going to help you have that strong relationship with money. Invest time to understand how to use money. Read books on it. Watch more videos like this one on money. Make sure that you're starting to build your knowledge around money. Because once you start to get some knowledge around money, and particularly having that confidence, you're going to start to attract more of it as well. You're not going to be frightened of it. Having the confidence to believe that you are going to attract that money is part of the formula for making sure that you do actually attract a lot of money. Wealthy people have this definite mindset about money. They respect it, they value it, they treat it wisely, and they want to bring more of it into their life. And that's how they treat it. They spend time looking at where they've spent their money. They spend time looking at where they've got positive return on some of the decisions that they've made. They don't waste money. They are very careful not to waste it because they know that it's valued. So making sure that you have that strong relationship with money is absolutely critical. So now, in order to make sure that you've got the right sort of money beliefs in your business, remember, understand where money has came from. Money is a means of exchange of value, which was our second point. Money is an idea backed by confidence, our third point. Our fourth point was about money and having the unhelpful beliefs and what you need to do to get rid of them. And finally, the fifth point was making sure that you've got healthy beliefs. If this video has been of great value to you, make sure you subscribe down below and also make sure you download the free copy of my book, Find Your Cash. And finally, if you want to get more confidence in how to understand money, there's a free course there. Thanks for watching. Look forward to seeing you on the next video.